गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर 21st लेक्चर ऑफ इकॉन 353। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन अबाउट दी डिफरेंट एग्रीकल्चर मार्केटिंग इंस्टीट्यूशंस वर्किंग फॉर कोऑपरेटिव सेक्टर। सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल सी अबाउट दी व्हाट इज कोऑपरेटिव मार्केटिंग, व्हिच आर द फंक्शंस ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव मार्केटिंग, व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव मार्केटिंग सोसाइटीज, एंड व्हाट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव मार्केटिंग सोसाइटीज। So firstly, cooperative marketing. So what is cooperation? Cooperation means doing any work by coming together. So in cooperative marketing is an extension or addition of the principle of cooperation in the field of marketing. So cooperative marketing is a process of marketing through a cooperative association formed voluntarily by its member to perform one or more marketing functions in respect of their produce. So cooperative marketing organizations are the associations of farmers or producers for the collective marketing of their produce and for securing the members. Okay, in other words, cooperative marketing is the marketing for the farmer by the farmer that aims at eliminating the chain of functionaries operating between consumers and farmers. As you know, there are the different marketing intermediaries operating between ultimate consumer and the farmer or the producer. So to eliminate this chain or to minimize the market margin, the cooperative marketing or cooperative associations are working. So cooperative marketing will help to increase the producer shares in consumer's rupee. Means farmers will get the good price because of the elimination of the marketing intermediaries. In a cooperative marketing society, the control of organization in the hands of the farmer. So total control of that organization is in the hands of the farmers or producer. The profit earned by the society is distributed among the members of on the basis of quantity of produce marketed by them or marketed by him. Means the profit earned by that society, it is also distributed among the members of that society. So in other words, cooperative marketing societies are established for the purpose of collectively marketing and marketing of the products of member farmers. So what is the purpose behind establishment of cooperative marketing societies? To market their product collectively. It emphasizes the concept of commercialization. Its economic motives or its economic aim and character differentiate it from the other association. So this is about the cooperative marketing and cooperative marketing societies. Now we will see different functions of cooperative marketing societies. There are 10 functions of a cooperative marketing society. So first one, to market the produce of member of the society at fair prices. So it is a primary or basic function of cooperative marketing society to market the produce of the member farmers of the society at a fair price in a market. Second, to safeguard the members for excessive marketing cost and malpractices. Means to safeguard the member farmer from the excessive marketing charges or excessive marketing cost gained by the marketing intermediaries and the agents, and malpractices also. To avoid such malpractices and avoid such extra charges, the cooperative marketing societies are working. This is the second function. Third, to make credit facilities available to the member against the security of the produce brought for sale. Means these societies also provide a financial support to the member farmer. This is third. Fourth one, to make arrangement for specific storage facilities for the member farmers produce. So this society also make an arrangement for storage structures to store the produce of member farmers. Then fifth one, to provide facilities of the grading and market information also provided, which may help them to get a good price in a market. So these societies provide the grading facilities as well as they provide the market information about the current prices arrival, demand and supply of that particular product. Then sixth one, to introduce the system of pooling so as to acquire better bargaining power than the individual member having a small quantity of produce for marketing purposes. Suppose if a single seller or single farmer will go to sell their produce, they will not get a good price because their quantity is very less. If the farmers, they go in a group for to sell their produce, they will get the good price in a group or in a association. Okay. Then next is to act as an agent of the government for the procurement of food grain and for the implementation of price support policy. So such cooperative marketing societies acts as an agent of government for the procurement or for the transaction of the food grains and for implementation of price support policies, means for implementation of minimum support price or MSP. Then next, to arrange for the export of produce of the members so that they may get better return. So such cooperative marketing societies also arranges the export facilities to the member farmers produce. So it is difficult to export produce of a single farmer, so they produce through this cooperative marketing societies, or they export through this cooperative marketing societies. Then next, to make arrangement for the transport of produce of the member from the villages to the city market on a collective basis and bring about the reduction in the transportation cost. If, as we know, in a total marketing cost, transportation cost is the very highest cost, to minimize such a transportation cost, the member farmers, they collectively transfer their produce from village to market area so that they can reduce the per unit or per quintal cost of marketing, cost of transportation. Then last is to arrange for the supply of the inputs required by farmer, such as improved seeds, fertilizer, insecticide, pesticide, etc. So such cooperative marketing societies also provides the farm inputs like seeds, improved variety seeds, then some fertilizers, insecticides and pesticides, etc. So these all are the functions of cooperative marketing societies. Now next, most important is, which are the types of cooperative marketing societies? So based on the commodities deal or commodities transacted by them, there are the three types. First one, single commodity cooperative marketing society. Second one, multi-commodity cooperative marketing society. And third one, multi-purpose multi-commodity cooperative marketing societies. So we'll see one by one. So first one, single commodity cooperative marketing societies. So its name indicates that this type of societies deals in the market only with only one agricultural commodity. So they are the single commodity cooperative marketing societies. They get sufficient business from the farmer producing that a single commodity. For example, sugarcane factory is there, cotton, oil mills, okay, these seed oil seed growers cooperative marketing societies. So they are the only related to a single commodity. Now next is multi-commodity cooperative marketing societies. So as we have seen, in a single commodity, that society is related to only one commodity. In a multi-commodity, these societies are deal in the marketing of large number of commodities or large number of different commodities produced by farmers, such as food grains, oilseed, cotton, pulses, etc. So most of cooperative marketing societies in India are of this type. So keep in mind, multi-cooperative marketing societies are very large number, are in the very large number in India, because they are dealing with different types of commodities. Okay. And last type is multi-purpose multi-commodity cooperative marketing societies. As name indicates that, multi-purpose means these societies have a different purposes behind their establishment. So these societies market a large number of commodities, because these are the multi-commodity, and perform such other functions as providing credit to farmer members, arranging for the supply of inputs by them, meeting their requirements of essential domestic consumption goods also. So these are the purposes, there are the different purposes behind the establishment of such societies. That's why these societies are multi-purpose, multi-commodity cooperative marketing societies. So this is all about the types of cooperative marketing societies. So next is structure of cooperative marketing societies. This is most important part of this, in this topic is structure. It may be asked for your semester end examination. Give the structure of cooperative marketing societies in India. So the cooperative marketing societies have a both type of structure, that is two tier structure and three tier structure. As we have learned in a finance, okay, in a course of finance credit, there is also a two tier and three tier structure. Here also in a cooperative marketing societies, there are two tier and three tier structure. In the states like Assam, Bihar, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Orissa, Rajasthan, West Bengal, they are adopting the two-tier pattern with primary marketing societies at tahsil level or at block level, taluka level, and directly state marketing federation at state level as a apex body. So there are only two tiers. First one is at primary and second one is at state level. So in our state, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Punjab, Manipur, Tamil Nadu, Uttar Pradesh, Pondicherry, there is a three-tier structure, or these states are adopting the three-tier structure of cooperative marketing societies, in that with district market society in the middle. In the middle means first one is primary PACs, primary agriculture cooperative societies, then district cooperative society, and last apex body is state cooperative societies. So at national level, NAFED serves as a apex institution in a cooperative marketing societies. As we have seen in last lecture, NAFED is National Agricultural Cooperative Marketing Federation. Okay, then three tier structure of cooperative marketing societies. In three tier structure, there are the three levels. So first one is base level. Base level means at a village level. So at a base level, there are primary cooperative marketing societies. They market the produce of the farmer members in that particular area. They may be single commodity or multi commodity societies, depending upon the production of that crop, production of crop in that particular area. Because as we know, region wise or area wise, crop, different crops are produced in our India. So they are located at a primary wholesale market, and their field of operation extend to the area from which produce come for sale, which may cover one or two tahsils, panchayat samitis, or development blocks. So this is a base level in a three tier structure. Second, at a regional or district level cooperative marketing societies, this is a second level in a three tier. At the regional or district level, there are central cooperative marketing unions or federations. It is at a district level. So their main job is to market a produce brought for sale by the primary cooperative marketing societies of the area. So primary cooperative marketing societies, they sell their produce to district level, and district level sell their produce to state level. So these are located in the secondary wholesale markets and generally offer a better price for the produce. The primary cooperative marketing societies are the member of these unions in addition to the individual farmer member. So at a base level, societies are the member of the district level societies. In two tier structure, the state level societies perform the function of district level societies by opening branches at the district level throughout the state. In two tier structure, the district level also perform the function of the state level societies, but in a three tier structure, there is a different function of district level societies. And last one or last level is state level. At a state level, there are APEX state cooperative marketing societies or federation. These state level institutions serve the state as a whole, means their functional area is as a whole state. Their members are from both primary cooperative marketing societies and from the central cooperative unions of the state. Means the members of state level cooperative societies are from base level and from the regional or state district level also. The basic function of these is to coordinate the activities of the affiliated societies and conduct such activities as a interstate trade, export import, procurement, distribution of inputs, consumer goods, and dissemination of market information, and rendering the expert advices to the member farmers and to the member cooperative societies. So this is all about the cooperative marketing societies. So for this topic, you can refer the book of Agriculture Marketing in India, Acharya and Agrawal. Then another book is there, Agriculture Economics by Subba Reddy. Thank you.